yo, yo, we're in Bonaire. It's nice and hot. Gonna go and have some fun.
We're just about to do our first shore dive ever. We'll have to navigate our way to this huge wreck on this slope that goes down to more than 100 feet. And we're all really excited to just get out diving again.
Let's do it! Woo!
Today the Aquateam is on the island of Bonaire in the Dutch Antilles. We're diving the wreck of Our Confidence, a Jewish refugee boat from the Second World War.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Hey guys. Which one of you is Rob?
That'll be me.
Hey. Hey, welcome guys. First time on Bonaire?
Yeah.
I heard you guys want to do Our Confidence, the wreck?
Yeah.
It's cool.
The whole of Bonaire is a marine park and you're not allowed to wear any gloves while you're diving. No knee padding, no elbow padding, no spear fishing, no taking anything with, no touching anything. That one's important to me. So if you touch the reef, it dies. A lot of people don't realize this, but please, 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 just putting your finger on, looking at another bit of reef, it dies. Be really careful.
So how do the currents look today, do you think?
Well, it's just a case of checking. No current. Okay.
And how could you tell that?
The wind's always off land here. You see the boat line? The rope is a bit slack. It's not totally tight. So I'd say this boat is hanging on the wind. No current.
Okay. Good thing for this.
That doesn't mean that it's not a current at Our Confidence.
Oh.
Because Our Confidence is lying in the harbor mouth and all the water that's being blown in to the harbor has got to come out. So you got a small riptide that's got the tendency to curl around the corner to our place over here. I actually had it a couple of times I couldn't get there.
It's kind of intimidating him saying that sometimes he doesn't even make it to the dive site. Considering he's a diver himself, he's probably been doing it for years. And we're kind of new to diving, so finding a current might be a little difficult for us. But I'm pretty sure all of us will be able to make it.
Yeah, sure, we'll be able to do it.
How many meters away is our
call? Rough guess, 100 to 150 meters to the left.
So should we get going and get in the water before the current starts?
You've got to do your mandatory check dive in front of the shop, which means you check yourself. You check for your lead, your weight, your buoyancy and everything. After that, you can do whatever you want on your own. Then we can go for a check dive if you want.
Let's do it.
Yeah? Get your weights.
So you're nicking each other's weights.
We put the wrong weights on. I took Joe's and Joe took mine back.
I think it was my bad, though. It's a good thing we caught it, because I'd be floating the whole time. She'd be
I'd
sunk
be, like,
to the
drowning.
Bottom.
Everyone would just call me the reef murderer.
According to Rob, we need to do a check dive.
Because this is all like a marine sanctuary.
There's tons of reefs, aqua life.
There's a lot of like protected coral and stuff.
Which is pretty neat.
So I think they just want to make sure that we know what we're doing so that we won't hurt any of the coral or marine life.
Cuckoo, I need help, man.
Are you sure it's not this? Because
this buckle.
Oh. Today we're doing a shore dive. We're not used to being on shore and suiting up and getting all our sand stuck to us.
There you go.
Oh my God. There
you go.
Oh. Before, I used to getting on a boat.
Are you stuck?
And having all of our gear ready and jumping into the water. And we're not used to carrying it across the beach. And it was just like hot desert sand.
I want to get in the water.
It's hot, but the sun isn't shining on us.
How are you doing there, guys?
I'm just not going to get my head.
Good. Good-o.
Warm?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Actually,
that
not
means
really.
You got good wetsuits.
We figured that out.
I'm going to walk up there. As you can see, there's a bit of a stone sticking out there. It's quite slippery, so what you want to make sure of is that you got good footing and then put your weight in. If you walk normal, you'll go down. There is a platform at about 15 centimeters depth, so you'll be standing about this far. I'll go in first so you can see. And then from there, I'm going to just float about. Put your mask on first. Look around if you're not doing any damage. That's important to me. Not you being damaged, but you doing damage to the underwater world. Then put your fins on. Be careful with that, because there's a lot of fire coral growing everywhere here. Shall we go?
Yeah.
You guys all did a body check?
Yeah.
You all got your buddies?
Yeah.
Let's go.
So what does the fire coral look like?
I'll show it to you. It's light brown with white edges.
And if you touch it?
Oh, man. That stuff gives you blisters.
So why are we entering the water this far away from the wreck?
Because the actual reef starts from that pole onwards. So if you jump in there, you got to swim all the way back. What we're going to do now is do your check dive. You couldn't come out, and then we'll do our surface interval, nice and proper, and then we'll go and see our confidence.
Very neat.
Cool?
Be very careful.
Help each other, eh? You're a buddy team.
Are you okay?
Good.
So that's a fire coil there?
That's fire coil.
Whoa! Oh, you pictured it. You pictured it.
Careful, buddy. Hang on.
Whatever. This is the symbol for fire coil.
Okay, you guys, there's
I think everybody just had fun doing it.
One small step for you, one giant leap for mankind.
Checo dive, we're checking out our weight so that our buoyancy is correct.
Buoyancy meaning just so we're weighted properly in the water.
Is anybody freaked out about that slope? Because I looked down and it kept on going and it didn't stop. What do you guys think of the visibility today?
Really, really good.
I thought it was good.
Lying in the sun on the beach. Sharks out there, I think I saw a fin. Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
It's really important to maintain complete perfect buoyancy, because even just the slightest loss of buoyancy, you would sink and hit the reef, and that kills the coral. And that's not good, because even though you might think it's a rock or a shell, it's actually made of tiny little creatures, and they're a really important part of the food chain. So it's our responsibility to keep it alive while enjoying the beautiful dive on the reef.
Isn't really coral at all. It's actually related to jellyfish, and it stings just as bad.
When we are down at the deepest point, you look up and the slope's just like straight up. Some of us were a little wonky.
Going up the slope, you had to keep like adjusting your buoyancy.
Not Rob though.
He was like skimming the bottom instead of not touching it.
Well, we're gonna be like that eventually.
Eventually.
We're getting a lot better at that.
We are though.
Yeah.
I can kind of tell because there's not as much like pushing up.
If I don't jump ship right now, I'll never figure out how to fly.
Your first dive on one air.
There's so much fire coil down here.
At one point we were like at the back of the buoy thing and you look up and it's like scary.
Some things are like paper thin.
We're going to go out the water, do a surface interval, and then we'll go to our conference.
How long is the surface interval going to be?
Not that long.
Good.
Rob's happy with all our dive skills. Now the shipwreck. The buddy system is important when you're shore diving because it's harder to get in and out of the water. Everyone needs help.
Water's amazing. I like how it went on the slant because you didn't know what was beyond the world.
Hey Jordan, man, where's Gwyneth?
The Aquateam is on the island of Bonaire in the Dutch Antilles. We've just finished our checkout dives to prove we're good enough divers to dive on a shipwreck called Our Confidence.
Aquateam's amazing. I liked how it went on the slant because you didn't know what was beyond the whoa.
You okay?
Yeah. So I was coming up the stairs, I took off my booties and everything, and I was coming up the stairs and I slipped and my BC came off of my tank.
Did it really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, you did do a body check, didn't you?
Yeah.
It seems tight. Gwen, what happened to you?
I took my booties and my fins off and I was coming up the stairs and the stairs were pretty slippery, so I fell.
Oh.
And
God,
my tank slipped off and everything got messed up.
Where was your buddy?
You were eating. Actually.
Jordan.
No excuses, man.
Yeah.
Okay, we are about to do our dive on our confidence. This is a like historic site. And 5 years ago, there was a video survey taken about what the site looks like. And because of the current, there's a lot of damage being done. So we are going to take another survey 5 years later. And we have some of the footage taken from the 5 year ago survey. Check it out. Okay, this is the starboard side of our confidence.
It looks like a big ship.
It's a bird's eye view. You can see the mast here, and then that's kind of the front of the ship right there.
It looks like it's pretty breasted on the top.
Yeah, like that, I don't know, coral might have gotten into it.
Do you know what the story is on the wreck?
I don't know what the story is, but I think Rachel does.
Yeah, it's a Jewish refugee ship from World War II, trying to escape from the Nazis. And so they came over here for the Dutch Antilles, and then it became a trading ship. 10 years ago, it sank, and we don't know why, so that's really the main mystery of the story.
Cool. So you have to get tags to dive in Bonaire, and I have them right here for you. This is pretty much like your license plate to go diving.
Awesome. So we need these to go scuba diving?
Yep. And you just have to fasten them to your BCDs.
So this is us pretty much saying we're not going to do anything to the reefs or the wreck?
Yeah.
Okay.
So let's go.
All right.
Do this.
Glenn, are you excited?
I'm pretty excited for this dive because it's a really interesting boat and there's so many mysteries about it.
I think it'll be pretty cool because the boat's right on a slope.
Mm-hmm.
So it should look pretty interesting having the coral like slanted and the boat's just like placed there perfectly on the edge.
So what do you think of the current that dive?
You know, you can sort of feel it come across you, but
it wasn't that bad at all, but I think it's picking up now. I just see the boats, they're getting taken by the current, so I think it's picking up a little bit. We better get in there.
Yeah, because the ropes are tight.
Yeah, and Rob said that usually mid-afternoon is when the currents really pick up, so we better get out there soon.
All right, so let's go get the troops and do this second dive.
Okay, let's go.
And when you get deeper, the coral, there's more live coral.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Ready for the dive?
Yeah.
Okay, we have the map. So we just have to follow the edge of the slope all the way to the fourth mooring. And then right above that is where the wreck is. So the current's picking up, but it's still manageable. So we find the wreck.
And if you're not sure, just follow us.
Okay. Are we swimming underwater or above water?
I think we're swimming under.
Yeah.
Or else we might not be able to see the blocks.
Guys, this right here is the first mooring, right there. Right there.
Oh, and that's how far apart they are? It's only like
it's a quick little
300
swim.
Meters.
Oh, well, that's nothing.
Okay. But did you say the current's picking up? Like
yes,
more than it was when we were
it is
before?
Picking up.
It's coming in this way.
Yeah, it's going this way.
We've got to
way,
swim
so
against it.
But if we swim underwater, the current will be less.
It won't be that
way.
Bad.
It won't be.
Yeah. It won't be
yeah.
That bad.
Hopefully.
So you guys ready?
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's get set up.
This.
Pretty good.
I'm so excited to get in the water.
Yeah,
and like
too.
So hot and this is heavy.
Well, I haven't seen a shipwreck yet. Some other people have, but I haven't.
One, two,
three. Our tank's gonna stay on, okay?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay, guys, you all set? Let's all get in the water.
I'm really pumped for the second dive, particularly because it's my first shipwreck, and also because it has to do with my Jewish heritage. I'm really excited to be documenting a piece of Jewish world history. So the current has picked up a little bit, and we have to fight a little bit more than I thought we had to.
You're like kicking and kicking and kicking, and you're going like that.
I really noticed the current was when there was this big rock, and I think I passed it like four times because I'd like go and then we'd go again.
It was really difficult. The current was getting stronger, it seemed, by the second. So by the time we got there, a lot of people were already at like 1,000 PSI. That's less than a half tank of air, which means we could run into some trouble on the way back. After all that work swimming against the current, it was so amazing to see the wreck emerging out of the gloom. We're going to document our confidence. And we're going to compare the video from today to the video from 5 years ago. That way, we can see how fast it's breaking apart. What I basically did was just circled the ship, went above the ship. I had a camera and I took a lot of pictures.
It looked like it was tilted more than it had been before, and there was like no wood. There was like just strips.
In the pictures you saw, the mast was up straight.
Before there was an actual like cabin, but that whole thing was just gone.
Joseph and I, we saw the steering wheel of the boat actually on the bottom.
It's actually really cool to see all the fish weave through it.
Rachel and I decided to swim on top of our confidence just to get a bird's eye view. And I just exhaled. And when you exhale, you go down. And my fin just lightly hit a sideboard or something. And the whole thing just kind of went down. I was like freaking out. So I guess I wasn't thinking about my buoyancy very much.
It just shows how delicate it is, like all the water hitting it for so long that just like the slightest little hit can make it just crack.
At one point I was actually like under like the hull of the boat. It was right by the propeller. Gwyneth ran out of air at that point.
I had about 0 PSI.
Hung out of the wreck for not even 20 minutes, I guess. The way back was really easy because you're going with the current.
I started running out of air, and then I just did a buddy thing with Rachel and used her alternate air source.
So how'd you guys like the wreck?
It changed so much from the picture.
How much air does everybody have left?
I have 500.
It took us a long time to get there, and then it was so quick coming back. You could tell there was a current.
We fought the current.
Yeah, but it wasn't a current.
So, let's get out of the water.
Yeah, let's get out.
Let's
get
that much.
So what'd you guys think of the wreck?
I thought it was so cool because it was my first wreck that I got to see, like the shipwreck. So when I saw it, I was like, oh my god, and Kumi's just like, I've seen one before. I'm just like, but it's so cool, look. So I thought it was amazing.
Yeah. I'd actually be really interested in seeing the pictures again, like the pictures that we saw on the computer.
Just compare.
Yeah, exactly, to compare.
Aquateam is in the Dutch Antilles. We just finished taking underwater video of the shipwreck, Our Confidence. It's a Jewish refugee boat from the Second World War. Nobody knows why it sank.
It was lying in the harbor and it started making water. They don't know why it started making water. So they used the Harbor Queen, which is quite a big dive boat from a harbor village next door. They used it to tug it out and they wanted to bring it out to open sea, i.e. between Klein Bonaire and Bonaire, but they never made it because it sunk too quick and they don't know what sunk it, they don't know what the leak made, they don't know where the leak was. It just sank.
Every diver who comes to Bonaire makes up their own theory about the sinking of Our Confidence. But since the wreck is deteriorating so fast, the truth may never come out. When you compare today's video with the video from 5 years ago, you can really see how fast it's breaking apart.
It was amazing how much wood deteriorated.
It was full of holes. The mast had totally tipped over.
The deck is totally gone, and there's hardly anything left of the hull.
It's weird to think that the current could do so much damage. Like, and I know it has been
but
5 years.
Over so much time.
Yeah.
It's amazing that I got to see a piece of my own history in person. But it's breaking apart and slipping away every day. And I'm really happy that I got to help document it and preserve the story of our confidence.
I'll sit in.
What?
I'll sit in.
Okay.
How awesome
is this?
Oh, this actually feels really good.
This is really nice.
Oh my god. Someone let go.
Cameras and regulators only.
Cameras and regulators only.